Hello, I'm Konstantin Zhelyukhin from Department of Mathematics, and today we continue to study systems with constant coefficients, linear systems. We know that to solve such a system, we need to find eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the coefficient matrix. And today we will consider the case of complex eigenvalues. It's possible for a matrix with real entries to have complex eigenvalues. Let me give you an example, very simple one. So we can see the matrix A with entries 0, 1, minus 1, 0. Then if we try to find eigenvalues of matrix A, we have to solve the following equation. Determinant A minus lambda I equal to 0. Right, and in that case, it simply leads to minus lambda 1 minus 1 minus lambda. So that would be lambda square plus 1 equal to 0. And we see that lambda square is equal to minus 1, which implies that lambda is equal to plus minus I. Lambda is equal to plus minus I. I is imaginary unity, and it has the following property. I square is equal to minus 1. I square is equal to minus 1. So even for such simple matrix with real entries, we can have complex eigenvalues. To deal with complex eigenvalues, we will need some review about complex numbers. So let me do review on complex numbers. Right. So what is a complex number? A complex number Z can be represented as Z is equal to A plus IB. A plus IB. Here we have that A and B are real numbers, and I is a complex unity, imaginary unity, sorry. Imaginary unity. So again, we have I square is equal to minus 1. I square is equal to minus 1. Some terminology about complex numbers. A is called the real part of Z, and B is called imaginary part of number Z. Imaginary part of number Z. When we have complex numbers, we can do all the operations with complex numbers. Addition, multiplication, division, subtraction, and all the usual laws are satisfied. Addition and multiplication are commutative. They satisfy associative law and related by the distributive law. For example, if we have two complex numbers, Z1 equal to A1 plus I B1, and Z2 equal to A2 plus I B2, if we have two such complex numbers, then we have that Z1 plus Z2 would be A1 plus A2 plus I times B1 plus B2 plus I times B1 plus B2 and if you have Z1 times Z2, that would be A1, A2 minus B1, B2 plus A1, B2 plus A2, B1, I. So this is two operations, addition and multiplication. To proceed further, we need one more operation, so-called conjugation. So let me introduce conjugation for complex numbers. We need one more operation, which is called conjugation. For a complex number z, a plus ib, we define conjugate of z as follows. Notation is z bar, and it is equal to a minus ib. So this is definition of the conjugate, a minus ib. Now some properties of the conjugate. If we have, so for z1, z2 complex numbers, we have that z1 plus z2 conjugate is equal to z1 conjugate plus z2 conjugate, and if we take z1 product z2 conjugate, that would be z1 conjugate times z2 conjugate. So you can now calculate conjugate of sum and conjugate of products from conjugates of z1, z2. And one more observation is the following one. If you take z plus z conjugate, you get exactly two real parts of z. So that would be 2a. And if you get z minus conjugate of z, you get exactly two imaginary parts of z. Two i imaginary parts of z. So you have 2i times imaginary part of z. So it would be 2ib. And the last one, if you get z times its conjugate, then you get a square plus b square. So you get a real number. This real number is actually square of the absolute value of z. Okay. Right. So we will need this conjugate. To proceed further, we will need also to take exponents of complex numbers. Remember that to construct a solution, we have to take an exponent of eigenvalues. So we have to learn how to take exponents of complex numbers. And we will use so-called Euler formula to take exponents of complex numbers. So Next, it would be so-called Euler formula. And we have the following lemma. So, let theta be a real number, then e to the I theta is equal to cosine theta plus I sine theta plus I sine theta. So let us evaluate, let us prove this lemma. Let us see how we can evaluate exponent of e I theta. Right, so proof. Well, proof is very simple, and it's based on the definition of exponent. So for a complex number z, we define exponent as sum n from 0 to infinity z to the n divided by n factorial. So if we have e to the I theta, that would be equal to sum I from 0, n from 0 to infinity I theta divided by n factorial, I theta to the n divided by n factorial, and it would be convenient to separate even and odd powers of I. So we have even powers of I, integral from k to 0 I theta to the power 2k divided by 2k factorial plus sum again k from 0 to infinity I theta to the power 2k plus 1 divided by 2k plus 1 factorial. And if you take I to the power 2k, it's I squared to the power k, so minus 1 to the power k. And here we can take 1 I out, and again we will have I to the power 2k, which is minus 1 to the power k. So 1 can continue. One can continue and write that that would be equal to sum k from 0 to infinity minus 1 to the power k theta to the power 2k divided by 2k factorial plus sum k from 0 to infinity sum I times sum k from 0 to infinity theta to the power 2k plus 1 divided by 2k plus 1 factorial. So we have such sum. And as you remember from calculus, this is exactly the series for cosine, and this is exactly series for sine. So we have cosine theta plus I sine theta plus I sine theta. And we prove that lemma. Yes, we proved that lemma. So we proved so-called Euler formula. So this formula is called Euler formula. And that Euler formula help us to evaluate exponent of any complex number. So as a corollary, to the lemma, we can have that e to the a plus I b, so any complex number can be written in that form, is equal to e to the a cosine b plus I sine b. So we have that simple formula which help us. That is enough about complex numbers. We don't need to know more to construct solutions. And let us return to our linear systems. So let us return to our linear systems. Right. Let us consider a linear system and assume that coefficient matrix of that system has a complex eigenvalue. A linear system d over dt x is equal to a x, where a is a constant real matrix. Where a is a constant real matrix. And suppose that A has a complex eigenvalue. Lambda equal to A plus IB. And to that complex eigenvalue correspond the complex eigenvector. So with complex eigenvector, W, we will write it in the following form. U1 vector U1 plus I vector U2. So U1 and U2 are real vectors. So U1 and U2 are real vectors. Right. So when we have these real vectors, what we have this complex vector, complex eigenvalue, we can use our formula to construct a solution. But unfortunately, that solution would be complex one. So we can construct a complex solution. A complex solution Z. Let me write Z1. So which would be e to the lambda? Okay, let me write Z. E to the lambda times W. E to the lambda times W. Lambda T. E to the lambda T times W. Well, this is a complex solution, and formally it solves our system, but we would like to have a real solution. Everything is real. Yes, our matrix is real, and we want to have a real solution. So somehow, using this complex solution, we have to produce two real solutions. Well, to produce real solutions, the following observation helps. It turns out that such complex solutions come in conjugate pairs. What I mean that if lambda is an eigenvalue, then lambda bar would be also an eigenvalue, and corresponding eigenvector would be W bar. So complex eigenvalues and complex eigenvectors come in conjugate pairs. Let me show this. I will formulate it as a lemma. Right, so lemma, let A be a real matrix. A real matrix. Then, if lambda equal to A plus IB is a eigenvalue of A, is an eigenvalue of A with an eigenvector with an eigenvector W equal to U1 plus I U2. So again, U1, U2 are real vectors as A, B are real numbers. So if we have that one, then lambda bar conjugate of lambda A minus IB is also an eigenvector, eigenvalue of A. With an eigenvector W bar. So it's a bit involved notation, but we are not going to use it much, so let me write it. So we will have U1 minus I U2. So we have a conjugate pair of eigenvalues and conjugate pair of eigenvectors. Proof is very simple. Proof, right? So what we do? Because lambda is eigenvalue, we have that A applied to W is equal to lambda W. Then, taking conjugate, we can get that A, right, times W conjugate is equal to lambda W conjugate. And using properties of the conjugation, we have that that would be A conjugate times W conjugate, which is lambda conjugate times W conjugate. And because A is real matrix, its conjugate equal to L A itself. So we have that A W conjugate is equal to lambda W times W conjugate, which exactly means that lambda is eigenvalue and W is corresponding eigenvector. So we proved that lemma. And now you will see that it would be very easy to construct real solutions using that lemma. So let us return to our linear system. So recall that we have a system let's say the system, it's the same system as before. D over dt x, A x, where A is real constant matrix. And we assume that it has a complex solution. it has a complex solution z equal to e to the lambda t times w. Then, by the lemma, z bar is also another complex solution. Is also a solution. Well, lambda bar is eigenvalue, this is eigenvector, so if you use that formula for the solution, you get a solution. So we can say that by the lemma, this is also a solution. And remember that our system is a linear system, and linear combination of solutions is also a solution. So we can now take linear combination of z and z bar and produce real solutions. So taking linear combination, let's say linear combinations, of z and z bar, we get real solutions. X1, which would be 1 over 2 z plus z bar, and this is exactly real part of z. We get two reals, and second solution, x2, which is 1 over 2 I z minus z bar, which is exactly imaginary part of z, of solution z. Now we know how to construct real solutions corresponding to complex eigenvalues, and let's see how everything works in examples. Right. Let's consider examples. So let's do example one. Example. Solve the system. D over dt x is equal to 3 minus 2, 4 minus 1 x. Right. So let us solve such linear system. We know that we have to start with eigenvalues for coefficient matrix. So let's do eigenvalues. So we have determinant A minus lambda I must be equal to zero. This is matrix A, which give us the following one. 3 minus lambda minus 2, 4 minus 1 minus lambda, that would be equal to 3 minus lambda times minus 1 minus lambda plus 8. And that is equal to lambda square minus 2 lambda plus 5 equal to 0. Right. We can easily solve that quadratic equation. There are many different ways, and I prefer to use formula for solutions of quadratic equation. So lambda 1, 2 would be 2 minus b plus minus square root of determinant. In that case, it would be 4 minus 20 divided by plus minus divided by 2a. So that would be 2 plus minus square root of minus 16 divided by 2. And square root of minus 16 is 4i. So that would be 1 plus minus 2i. 1 plus minus 2i. So we have two conjugate eigenvalues. 1 plus 2i and 1 minus 2i. We have two conjugate eigenvalues. Now we have to find eigenvectors and construct solutions. And it would be enough to use only one eigenvalue, because we will construct complex solution corresponding to that eigenvalue and take it real and imaginary part. Okay, let's do it. Right. Now we are looking for eigenvalues, eigenvectors. And to find eigenvectors, we solve a minus lambda I, lambda 1 I, applied to a vector v equal to 0. Now, that would lead to the following linear system. Let me write this linear system in the following way. So we will have, right, 3 minus 1 plus 2i minus 2, 4 minus 1 minus 1 plus 2i, 0, 0. So this is a coefficient of our linear system, and this is a zero vector, right? So let me, before I will start to simplify this matrix, let me just do subtraction. So we will have 2 minus 2i minus 2, 4 minus 2 minus 2i. So we will have such matrix. It would be convenient to divide everything by 2 to simplify. So we will have 1 minus I minus 1, 2 minus 1 minus I. So basically we already know that these two columns, rows, are linearly dependent. We can just take one of them and find eigenvector. But it's always good to check that indeed we can get zero. So in that way we will check that our eigenvalues are found properly. We didn't do any arithmetical mistake. So what I will do, I will take row one. I will, let's say, change first row one and row two. So let us change these rows, and that should be one, of course. No, two. Okay, two. So we interchange these rows. We will have 2 minus I minus minus 1 minus I, 1 minus I minus 1, 0. And then I will replace row 2 by row 1 plus minus, sorry, 1 plus I row 2. So remember that when we multiply by conjugate, we get a real number. And in that case, we get exactly 2. So we will have 2 minus 1 minus I. And here we will have 0. Zero, zero. So we found our eigenvalue properly. We found our eigenvalue properly. So now we have that, right? We have the following one, that 2v1 minus 1 plus I v2 equal to 0, and v2 is equal to c. V2 is a free variable. That give me the following, that v1 is equal to 1 plus I divided by 2 c, and v2 is equal to c. So we get vector v, which would be c times 1 plus I 1. 1 plus I divided by 2. And that give me, I can take any c. So let me take c equal to 2. And we have a eigenvector v1, which would be 1 plus I 2. And that eigenvector correspond to eigenvalue 1 plus 2i. So we have eigenvalue and we have this eigenvector. Now we are ready to construct a complex solution. So let us construct complex solution. Right, so we have a complex solution. Z, which would be e to the 1 plus 2i t times 1 plus I 2. Okay, that would be e to the t. e to the t cosine 2t plus I sine 2t times 1 plus I 2. And because we have to take the real and imaginary part of that solution, it's good to do the multiplication, just to multiply. So I will write z as e to the t, and if I multiply, it would be cosine 2t minus sine 2t. So I multiply everything by, I sine 2t, I multiply everything by 1. Now I will multiply by I plus I cosine 2t minus sine 2t. And here we will have 2 cosine 2t plus 2i sine 2t. So we have this big complex solution. And now we will produce real solutions. Real solutions. First real solution is x1, which would be e to the t, right, cosine 2t minus sine 2t to cosine 2t. And this is real part of z. Real part of solution z. So we take everything which has which is real. And we have second solution x2, which is imaginary part of z. And that solution x2 is e to the t sine 2t plus cosine 2t. And here we have 2 sine 2t. So we have imaginary part of z. Right. And we, this is x1, x2 are linearly independent. So we have a general solution. General solution. X, which is c1, x1 plus c2, x2. So we solve the system. X1, X2 are given here.